season coming up with the hedge funds and FIIs. I believe market will remain in the range plus or minus 200 Nifty points from here. Any major movements probably will happen only the next year. And moreover, today the more clarity about the Ireland package is giving the required fillip to the market. Overall, market should remain in the range.
So, you know, we came off about 7.5% from the high, and we're up about 2% today. You'd say the fall, and it was quite swift. If you looked at Friday session, the last 30, 40 minutes, you know, the ease with which the market came off, I think that is what, you know, stumped bulls a little bit. It was not the quantum of the fall, but the ease with which 10 minutes, you know, about 50, 60 Nifty points were off. So that's behind us, you believe?
That almost everything every time happens, Prashant. As they say, the markets go up on a staircase but comes down on escalator. So always it's bound to for the market to fall whenever it chooses to fall. So we should be ready for that kind of bad odd day. But considering the Ireland problem now, Chinese rate hike, whatever has to happen, that is behind us. I believe now most of the data points for this year, it seems to be slowly coming to a culmination. I think even if there is any Spanish or any Portugal issue or anything of that sort, I think will come up only in the new calendar. Overall, I believe with all subject to this volatility, but broadly we should remain in the range.
Okay, broadly we should remain in a range. This market went up on an escalator as well, I think, and it's came down pretty quickly at that as well. Okay, all right, let's talk stocks. Jagan, you track open offers, takeovers, etc. closely. So coming on Kane India, the offer was at 355 rupees per share. What we are picking up is that the deal might not happen. I think stocks has been close to about 315, 320 sort of levels. Any impact because of the deal not happening, if it does pan out that way?
That's a very major question, whether the deal happens or not. But in a multi-billion dollar deal, always there is a concern of slip between the cup and the lip. That always true across the globe. I believe with the 355 deal price, I think the share price is bound to be capped around 340, 345, even if deal goes through, because open offer related and subject to all the acceptance ratios and etc. So I believe if the share price is available in the range of sub 320, I think one can always buy, expecting the rally up to 340-345. Whereas for the guys who believe the deal will not happen at all, I think it's a clear sell. I think if the deal doesn't happen, I think the share price can go sub 300 very soon. But I believe finally the deal may be pulled through. I believe a lot of efforts have been pulled through, and a lot of lobbying has already been happening. One would like to believe deal happening than not happening.
Okay, all right. What about the IPO, which starts out on the 26th, MOIL? Have you looked at that one in detail? I think the price band gets announced today sometime. Any thoughts?
The manganese ore is one of those very niche companies in the world, Prashant, because what happens is very, very few companies who are exclusively manganese kind of companies. To that extent, I believe some of these hedge funds and FIIs who focus on these minerals and mines kind of investments, for them it may be an exciting proposition. But having said that, when comparison to other mines and minerals kind of play in India, be it Coal India or anything of that sort, MOIL is a much, much smaller player. We have to see that in that context. And also the performance and the turnover of the company, and I think still it has to go some way before getting into real scale and size. But for the niche investors, I think still there is a chance of making some money. I think that once the price band gets announced, more clarity will come in terms of valuation, but company-wise, there is fundamental strength.
The Shipping Corporation of India follow-on, what about that? That's next week?
The follow-on issues are always tricky in the sense it is an effort of trying to hit a moving target, because there is always an inherent competition between the market price and the issue price, unlike an IPO, because IPO is more like trying to hit a static target. That's why it's always tricky to sell FPO. But Power Grid has shown that if it is priced right and if the discount sustains between the market price and the issue price, there will always be excitement. Shipping Corporation is a quite decent company and in very nice space. But at the same time, the multiples in, at which this this industry works is a little tricky, a little on a lower side. But having said that, even shipping corporation should get fairly good subscription, provided it's priced right and if the discount sustains. It's like hitting the moving target.
All right, Jagan, we leave it at that. We're talking to you as always here on the show. Appreciate your time.